okay, this is for the future. If anyone sees a poster somewhere, Glory playing Unmasked now, and the ticket price, £5 or whatever, don't go. It's a waste of money. Buy the album. Don't go. If we ever get that crazy and take off the masks.
Well, I have to say that also, even though it's really hard to play with the costume on, it's so cool. It's really cool. It also, it's for me, it's much more interesting to play with the costume and have the character and the role than just go there and have a jeans and chop or t-shirt or whatever. Mm. So it also gives me a lot more.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, it's like a, it's a funny trend. Of course, living in Finland, you can see it. But there's a lot. I mean, it is kind of weird. I mean, we get this question quite a lot. That why is it that there are so many good metal bands coming from Finland? I don't know. How can we know? I mean, it just. Okay, remember when grunge was born, or grunge was, you know, in the beginning of 90s. It seemed that all the record labels wanted to find something from Seattle, in one city in the world. One city. That was the mecca of music, you know, for those 3 or 4 years. And right now it seems to be in harder rock music, it seems to be that the mecca of metal or, you know, hard rock music is Scandinavia. I don't know why. Well, well, I've been saying this, like, I've been repeating this like a mantra. Anybody who says that we're like war clearly doesn't understand war or Lordi, or neither one of us, because the only thing in common with our bands is that we both wear masks and we have guitars and drums. That's pretty much it, because musically we're completely different. Yeah, we both portrayed monsters, but so does Gene Simmons and so does Alice Cooper. And I think we're way more closer to Kiss and Alice Cooper than Gwar. I mean, and there are bands like Slipknot who also wear rubber masks and be like kind of like monsters. Well, I know it firsthand, you know, it took 10 years for us to get the record deal because the record label said there were two kinds of answers. There were either, okay, your music is nice, your music is cool, but you have to leave away the image. That is so silly, that is so stupid, that is so not there. You don't look anything like you sound. Or the other companies said that, yeah, you can have yourselves a record deal right away if you will play like really brutal and dark black metal, because your music sucks, but you look nice. But, you know, I banged my head to the wall for 10 years, for a full decade, and finally I found a guy who actually understood it, you know, at a record label. Please go to some website or whatever and check out how the business works, so you don't get screwed, you know, because that is something that you might enjoy the success for a year or two, and then you realize that there's nothing left for you. Let's face it, if we would be in the States, you know, in a big label, we would be just one band amongst hundreds of bands in the roster, and if we wouldn't sell immediately a million albums, they would kick us out. But if we are with a smaller label in the States, that works better for a band like us, because they are willing to put their energy to the band.